Hey, Paul from thetechgeeks.com. I've got another rough and ready on Unifi Access here. You'll have seen me on one of the other videos get my old garage door opener sorted using a Unifi Access hub door mini. Now today, I'm going to try and just finish that off with my gates, but I do have an issue here. I've got mains power, but I don't have Ethernet down here. So let's just have a look at those gates. So you'll see I've got these old gate openers. Well, these have been replaced because a truck bashed into them the other week. And just down the back here, hidden away, I've actually got the gate controller for it. So what do I have? I have power, but I don't actually have any Ethernet down here. So what I've come up with an idea in this box, because I've got mains power, I've got a four-way in here, got UDB. So a Ubiquiti Device Bridge. This we're going to use because it's going to be able to pick up the Wi-Fi, the Unifi Wi-Fi from the house. This is going to give us up to about 30 watts of power. So this will be enough to then power my UA Hub Mini. And my UA Hub Door Mini is then going to be connected to, not in the active state, we've got this turned off here, is going to have its 12 volt openers connected. Hopefully down to my box that's here, and then we'll work out which terminals we need to use to actually activate that. So the idea is going to get this mounted up onto the wall over here, nice and neatly out the way. I've already run through the gland here, the four-way, through my waterproof gland at the bottom. So I will then fix that, power it from the mains socket, and then hopefully this will come online and be seen through the Wi-Fi. Once that's been seen through the Wi-Fi and I've adopted it, then obviously my hub door mini will come online, and then I'll be able to complete the rest of the setup. Okay, so the basics of that is done. Got it fixed to the wall. Got mains power running into there from the four-way. The UDB has powered up, and you can see, probably just about see a white light there on the UA hub door mini. So now we just need to hop onto the computer and see if we can find that on the Wi-Fi network and get it adopted, and then we can do the final cabling and work out what terminals we need to connect to on the gate opener to make it all work. Okay, so I've jumped onto my computer because I've got a Ubiquiti Unifi wireless network, my UDB, because it's got power, has now called home. And on my EFG, which runs our network, we can see this option here is now waiting to adopt it. So let's just click on the adopt. This is going to add it into my wireless network and essentially now provide it joining to Wi-Fi, and then it's going to provide an onward LAN connection, which our Hub Mini is plugged into. So let's just give that a couple of minutes while it adopts. And then we'll work on what we can do with the Hub Mini after that. Okay, so it's adopted, but you can see now that it wants an update. So we'll just let that run through and do its update so that we've got everything on the latest version. It's running the latest version in networking, and then we'll be able to get on and do some configuration. Okay, so the device has just finished its update and we're just waiting for it to reboot. This is why it's gone offline at this moment in time. Now, I did make a statement that this was a PoE plus device, or 30 watts. Had been confused from a previous video that I'd done where I actually still make this work and make this work with a reader pro as well, but this is only a PoE, so it can only give up to about 15 watts of power. Now, I'm not going to be plugging a reader on this. I just literally need the door hub mini to be able to unlock the gate. And so I don't need anything else on there. So 15 watts should be ample power for us. So it's now fully updated and working. You can see on here, it's giving us the idea of how good its signal strength is, which I'm pretty happy about. Our port manager running over here is actually going to show us what VLAN this is on. I'm actually going to change this VLAN because I need this VLAN to be on the same network for the Hub Door Mini as the UNVR that runs this. So let me just pop this over onto the network that should run on, and we'll probably block all of those others and apply that. I'm just going to give this a nice label, UA Hub Dash
door-mini gate, main gate. Right, let's just see. This sometimes has broken things before, so we'll just see how that works. Let's just go back a screen while that updates. We can see obviously all our other settings through here. We can do a network override, but I'm quite happy for where this is connected. This is currently using its built-in antenna. We did plug the external on there, so I will add that on and change the settings for that, because that should give us a slightly better a wireless connection as well. So hopefully, let's just give that a few moments to come back to green, and hopefully everything is there. We'll just update this. So let's just put this UDB dash main gate. All right, and obviously I could put a network switch here or something like that if I wanted to, and give myself some more switch ports, because I've got mains power down there. I could put a little PoE switch in and then run Ethernet from there. So it's a good option. You can obviously use this just to get your connectivity there. So you don't have to be able to do your PoE power. You could then run to a PoE switch that's going to give out more power than this device, and be able to then plug in, you know, an LPR camera or an intercom with the door hub or a gate hub as well. So a great way of getting Wi-Fi maybe 50 to 80 meters or so from your house, or Ethernet through Wi-Fi. So that's now all updated and should be everything that we need to go on this. Now we probably just want to go and see if we can get our hub door mini to join our main setup. Now, because I changed my VLAN on that main port, I do just need to, I've just chosen power recycle here just to switch the power on and back off again, or off and back on again, sorry, that way around. Which should now hopefully force this hub door mini to pick up an IP address from this VLAN. Once we've got that VLAN picked up and that IP address, then we should be able to adopt it into our UNVR. So we're just going to give that a moment to update and find its IP, and then we'll carry on with the rest of the config. Okay, I've hit a bit of a snag in this. And there has been ongoing discussion about whether a UDB does properly support the VLANs. There are options to change its VLAN that it's running in. You can override it here. Obviously, we have in the port manager, we have the option here to change the VLAN of the device. It didn't seem to matter what I did. It always defaulted back to the main VLAN. So to get around this, I need this UA hub door to call home into a different VLAN. So I need it to be adopted so it knows where that IP address is. So to get around this, what I'm actually going to do is I'm going to take the hub mini, and I'm going to adopt it on the right network that it needs to be connected on. Then I should be able to connect it to the UDB, and it will then be able to find the UNVR that's in a different IP range, because it'll know which to talk to. So I'm just going to try that as an option round. Not the ideal, but hopefully is a way around it. Okay, so I've plugged this into my switch on the right VLAN, so the device is at least adopting. Obviously, what this does is basically does a set-in form. You can SSH into the device, you do a set-in form and tells it where the IP address of the controller is, the IP address of this UNVR. So I'm going to adopt this, and hopefully once this is actually adopted, it, as a result, it'll actually know where this IP address is, even though it will be over a slightly different subnet. So we can see that this has come online. It didn't need any updates. So what I'm going to hopefully go and do now is I'm going to go and plug it in again behind the UDB. And hope that it's going to call home and see be visible in here. Okay, so not the world's best workaround, but you can see it's on a completely different IP address than all of the others. But because we were able to adopt it and it did that set in form, then it now can actually call home over that UDB. Maybe when the VLANs are fixed, or maybe I needed a switch that supports the onward VLANs for it, maybe that would make it work. But in this instance, this is all I need to actually happen. So I should now be able to put this as, let's have a look at this as main gate. I said I didn't need any readers or anything else set next to this. And so really all I want to be able to do is see what I've done for a couple of the others, for instance, like my portico. What groups did I have set in here? I've got some assigned policies that I set up by the looks of it, so that I could control who managed this separately. So I may well sort those out in a minute. Let's have a look. I compare this with a device. So I have a G5 PTZ pointing to that. This is already is paired with another device. It's already paired with an access control gate or hub or door. That's okay. So I can bring that one into place for that. That gives me my shot there, which is pretty good. I can send my unlock just to check that works in a moment. Terminal manager is not done at the minute. Manage the policies. So I've got some default policies. So I'm going to create a new policy here and I'm going to call it main gate. This really just allows me to control who actually can manage this. So I'm only just putting the main gate in there. And then users, I can choose all users if I want to, or I can select specific users from this list that may have control and ability to do this. So let me just put in my users that I want to for this moment in time. And my schedule is always. And now I've created that, and now just those users have access to that. Looks like on my main entrance, I've maybe used a user group. Let me just have a look and see whether that's something slightly different I may have done. I hear user groups. So I could create a group, which would mean that I could always just put people in and out of that group instead of having to put them all in here in a list, but hopefully give you an idea of how this can actually be done. So that's my device. So all now I've really got to actually go and do is actually run the 12-volt cable from it and work out the terminals that I need to connect up.
Okay, so the next thing to do is get the case here off the actual gate opener, because all we're going to be doing is sending an open request or a request to complete the terminals. And I'm just going to try and see if there's a way of just getting the camera in here. So what we're interested in is all of those terminal blocks. They all have writing on the front of them. Let me just try and see if we can get in this way round or different way round. Let's just try and see what we can do. You can see that these have all got writing on them. So you want to just find the manual for your device. And what we're trying to do is look at one that's showing if we close that pair, then it will actually close the gate. And if we open them or send the same signal again, it will then send an open. So I'm just going to look that up and then we'll do a little test to prove that it works. Okay, so hopefully you'll be able to see here. So having read the manual, basically I know that if I complete the circuit between COM and TRTG, or TRG I think it is, then the gate will actually start opening and closing. So what I'm just going to do, let me just put this one in COM. We'll put this in properly, but I'm just trying to test to see if this actually works. So if we do this, you can actually now see that the gate will open and close when a signal is sent, as you can see. And then if I was to push it back in again, it will stop. And if I will push it again, it will restart. So the idea with this, remember, this is not going to hold how long it's going to start. All we're doing is sending an open or, well, we're just completing the circuit really from the hub door mini. So what we now need to just do is run our 12 volt cable from the hub door mini to those two terminals, not as active as dry, and then we'll be able to get this to open and close the gates. So we're going to plug our 12 volt in here. We're going to be using COM as our general main connection, and then normally this is going to be set normally open, which means this circuit by standard is open. When we close it, when we send a signal from the hub mini, it will actually send a close the circuit to our gate opener, and our gate opener will then know what to do. It's the same as what we just did earlier when we put the cable between the two connections there for it. What I'm actually going to do is I'm just going to unplug the hub mini now while I just get the cable through and set up so that I have no chance of doing any shorting if that was possible. You'll also see I've turned this off. It's not set on 12 volt. We're running dry contacts. We're not actually sending any power from this device. We're just closing a circuit. So that's why that is switched over there as well. Okay, so I've got my hub door mini there with its cables connected. If we just come on round to this side here, hopefully we can just get in behind the tree here, just show you just in here, where we go, just here. Those are my two cables that I've just connected in on those two connectors that we saw that could work. And now if we just come back down, hopefully we can see the screen, maybe get you some shadow here off my phone. Probably not so easy, but you get a rough idea of what's going on here. I'm going to just be able to hit the door, a gate open. You can hear the gates actually running, and you can see that they're actually closing. If I was to actually use the app on the phone again, I can actually stop those at that point. I can change the timeout on that, which is the settings inside Unifi Access. Now if I hit it again, it opens. So remember, this is not actually doing anything clever with the gates themselves. They're not running for a certain amount of time. All we're doing is setting a close or open signal, or just to basically complete the circuit to my gate opener. But now we can get on, if we wanted to, not part of this video, but we could actually set up the LPR camera to do license plate recognition or face recognition and open the gates and things like that automatically. So hopefully that's been useful, just a bit of a rough and ready of how to get a gate opener running with a Ubiquiti Unifi Access setup. And in this instance, I've used a Unifi Access Hub Door Mini. Hopefully that's useful. Head on over to our YouTube channel. We've got plenty more how-to, rough and readies, how to set up Unifi Protect, how to use Alarm Manager, how to set up some of these features we've been talking about. So why don't you head over there, subscribe, and stay up to date.